Hello, I'm Richard Frank, software engineer with Autodesk Plant Solutions. In this video, we introduce AutoCAD Plant 3D Catalog Builder. Like the Spec Editor, the Catalog Builder can create piping catalogs. However, the Catalog Builder is designed to help you create many components at once, rather than create one component at a time. You create catalogs in three steps. First, you create a template, which defines the component type and size ranges. Next, we enter the size detail using Microsoft Excel. And finally, we add the components to a new or existing catalog. Let's get started by creating a sample template. When we first create a template, the template is empty, so there are no components displayed. To add a component, we first choose a category, select a component type, and click New to add the part family. I'll add an elbow, and we have a choice of shapes here. I'll select CPB bend parametric graphic. And then specify the pressure class. And add a description for the part family. Now for the purpose of this demonstration, we're going to go straight into Excel and take a look at the size detail. We just click Export to Excel. Create the spreadsheet. And as a shortcut, I'm going to click again just to get a quick way to open the spreadsheet. So here we have size ranges of 4, 5, and 6 inches. You can click on the preview image to get the dimension detail. And you can also get dimension descriptions by hovering over the comments, the little red triangle in each of the dimension cells. You can see that the description, units, end type, and nominal size range are provided. Now, a reason that I wanted to quickly jump into Excel with just this one component is to show you a few things that are not provided, such as the outside diameter. I would like to get outside diameter from the template and set a different size range. So we click Settings, and here we can set some defaults for new part families. Here we set pressure class for any new elbows that we might create to 300 pounds. Now you can create long descriptions from long description styles. These are the same description styles that are used in the Spec Editor. But what I want to show you is in the Advanced Settings dialog. These settings provide defaults for different sizes when you create the spreadsheet, such as outside diameter. Now what I want to do here is to provide the outside diameter for 1, 4, and 12 inches and exclude the other sizes within that range. So I'm using the arrow key and hitting space to clear these checkboxes. So let's close the settings dialog and head back into the template. So far in this video, we have added one component, an elbow, using parametric graphics. Now, I want to add another parametric component, but this time I want to show you something that you cannot do in the Spec Editor. I want to create a T-shaped strainer. In the miscellaneous category, select strainer. The shape that we want is not available by default, but I know from the T's that the shape name is CPTB. So with the quick type in of CPTB, we can select the T shape from the list. The template now has two parametric components, an elbow and a strainer. Now we will add a block-based valve to the template. Before you can use AutoCAD blocks, you need to add port information using the plant part convert command. To learn more about Plant Part Convert, please watch the Spec Editor Part 3 video. And here we select the DWG and then specify the number of ports. I'm also going to set the size range to just 4 inches. Before we create the Excel spreadsheet, we want to set the strainer and the elbow to use the size defaults that we specified in the Advanced Settings dialog earlier in this video. So for the elbow, we set the upper size to 12 inches and select Use Custom Size List. And we do the same for the strainer. Now we are ready to export our three-part families to Excel and open the spreadsheet. Here we overwrite the XLS file that we created earlier. But for the block-based component, we select the block name for our one size. Here we see three sheets, one for each family. Now one tip I recommend is to paste zeros into the dimension cells to start. Dimensions that have a zero frequently indicate a default value. Now from our advanced default settings dialog, we have outside diameters available, so we can copy and paste these values into the dimensions column. Now reviewing the comments column, we see that zero defaults can be used for D2 and D3. We'll paste in the nominal diameter for the length, and I'll stick with the default values for everything else. For the elbow, we'll assign a value for diameter and angle. And again, use the default value for everything else, although later we'll see I probably should have entered something for the radius. We've now assigned the dimensions. But before we save the Excel worksheet and create the catalog, I wanted to show you how to use formulas to create a size description. You can use a long description style to assign descriptions, but formulas can be quite useful for the descriptions and more complicated dimensions. So we'll concatenate column J with the space and the size column B, and then copy and paste for the whole column. Now we save the spreadsheet. So far in this video, we have created a catalog builder template, added size detail in Excel, and now we can create the catalog. Back in the catalog builder, we'll click Build Catalog, select the XLS file we just saved. After some validation, the build catalog dial displays, and we can save as a new catalog file. And we'll navigate to the 2012 content folder and save a new sample.pcat catalog file. And there we have it. We have a new AutoCAD Plant 3D catalog. For the remainder of this video, we'll look at the new components in the spec editor, add them to a spec, and see what they look like in the model. We'll also show you how to use the plant snapshot command to create preview images. So here we'll load the spec editor and open the sample PCAT catalog. Here's our elbow. Now in the spec editor, we'll open up CS300. Select the sample catalog and add these new components to the spec. Now, I didn't add a size description in the catalog builder, but you can use the spec editor to set descriptions either in the catalog editor or the spec sheet. Let's set this one to a T-strainer description. And for the block-based component, we'll call this the custom valve. So let's save the spec and load AutoCAD Plant 3D to take a look at the model. So far in this video, we have created three components using the catalog builder and added them to CS300 using the spec editor. Now we'll open a model drawing, and from the dynamic piping palette, we can insert the block-based valve. Now we'll add the missing preview image in a moment. Now I should point out another tip. You do not need to insert each part or even add the parts to a spec first to see what they look like in the model. You can use the preview Lisp files that get created when the catalog is built. So here we'll load the Lisp file for the strainer. And we can see both sizes that we created. These are preview blocks, not spec parts. Now the last thing we'll do in this video is create the missing preview image. We can create preview images using the plant snapshot command. So we'll run the command and then specify we want 200 by 200 images. Now to create snapshots for the entire catalog, we choose R for repository and select the catalog file. Then we specify a folder to put the preview images in. Here we'll create a folder named 200 underneath the catalog. Now after plant snapshot completes, we can take a look at the preview images. And here we have a super short radius elbow, the strainer, and the block-based valve. So back in the modeler, we'll reload the spec by switching briefly to a different spec. And now we can see that the preview image displays in the dynamic tool palette. And that completes this video, where we have used the catalog builder to create a piping catalog. Thank you for watching.